In the last class, we were discussing about the terms related to spherical mirror. Terms related to spherical mirror. There are so many terms related to spherical mirror, that means both concave mirror and convex mirror. Whatever the terms we are discussing, that all the terms are applicable for both concave mirror and convex mirror. But now we discuss all the terms by taking the concave mirror. This is the concave mirror. Concave mirror, as we discussed earlier, it is a mirror formed from a hollow sphere whose one side is polished and other side is reflecting. So that means this concave mirror is part of the hollow sphere. If we complete this mirror, it forms a sphere. For a sphere, there will be a center point, and this center point is also applicable for this concave mirror. Therefore, this center for the sphere, that is also the center of this concave mirror. So we call this is the center of curvature. Center of curvature. Then the center point on the surface of mirror, that is pole. This is pole. Then the line joining, line segment joining the center of curvature and the pole, it is known as radius of curvature. Radius of curvature, it is very important term, that is measurable term, which we have to use for the spherical mirror. Other than these three terms, center of curvature represented by C, radius of curvature represented by R, pole is represented by P. Other than these terms, there are so many terms related to this mirror. For that, I take this concave mirror only. Now, this is the concave mirror, which has the reflecting part up to only this portion. And if we see that concave mirror, it is just like a ball, tennis ball, which is cut from one side, forms a spherical shape like this. And its outer edge, if we see the outer edge, it forms a circle. And that will be seen like this. This is the mirror, concave mirror, and its outer edge will be seen like this, circular. This is the outer edge. And the diameter of that outer edge of that concave mirror, that is known as aperture. It is known as aperture. So for the study that in class 10th we are discussing about this mirror, in class 12th also you will discuss. In all these classes, we take all the spherical mirrors are having small aperture. Means the diameter of that circular edge of the mirror is smaller. The smaller aperture is taken to reduce all the defects taken place in the formation of the image formed by this spherical mirror. And that is the aperture. So all the mirrors will have the small aperture. And then the other term. Here this is the radius for this spherical mirror. You can draw many radius. This is also the radius. This is also the radius. There are so many radii can be drawn from the center of curvature to the surface. In mathematics, you must have discussed, studied about that the radius of any circle or any sphere makes 90 degree at the surface. So this is also making angle 90 degree at the surface. This point we discuss to know about one behavior of light, and from that we will get one point, one more term. That term is principal axis. The next term which we are going to discuss, that is principal axis. Principal axis, it is the line passing through center of curvature and a pole. It is the line. Line means it can be extended on either side. And that line passing through the center of curvature and a pole is known as principal axis. The basic nature of this principal axis is that whenever a light ray is traveling along this principal axis towards the mirror, strike the mirror and then reflect. After the reflection, that reflected ray will travel along the same path as it was traveling towards the mirror. Means we can say the reflected ray retraced the same path. It traveled back. This we are saying on the basis of law of reflection that we discussed in earlier classes. Law of reflection of light. So there are two laws of reflection of light. One is incident ray, reflected ray, normal lies on the same plane. Angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection at every point. Here the light ray which is traveling along the principal axis towards the mirror, that is incident ray. As it is traveling along the principal axis, the line which is joining C and P, that is center of curvature and the pole, it makes an angle 90 degree. That means 90 degree with the surface of mirror, that means the angle of incidence is 0. After reflection, it travels by making an angle 0. Therefore, the angle of reflection is also 0 and the reflected ray travel along the same path in the opposite direction. And that line is known as the principal axis. And then the other terms, one more term which we are going to discuss. The next term is the principal focus. Principal focus. The principal focus is a point on the principal axis at which all the reflected light rays meet. How they are going to meet at a point on the principal axis? If we take number of light rays which are traveling towards the mirror and parallel to principal axis, this is the incident ray. After reflection, it travels in a particular direction and that reflection takes place on the basis of law of reflection. Here, this is the angle of incidence. Because the C and the point on the surface, the line segment joining this is the normal. So, on the basis of law of reflection, the reflected ray travels in this direction with the same angle, that is law of reflection. If we take this light ray, here also, it is the normal and it reflects. Here the angle of incidence, angle of reflection, they are same. If we take many light rays, all the light rays meet at a single point, and that point on the principal axis is known as principal focus. That is represented by capital letter F. Okay?